to have another go at a bit of constructed action. Since yesterday, I've adapted my deck a little bit. I'm not running into quite as much Warlock as I was before. At least not of the sort of fast-paced zoo variety. So what I've done is I've taken out a Harvest Golem, I've taken out a Bloodlust, I've added in a Stalag and a Fuegen.
Thrall versus
and what else have I done? I've added an Ancestral Spirit as well. Right, let's have a think. What's good against Valera? I think we'll keep the Lightning Bolt. We prefer an Earth Shock, and there it is. I can't remember what I removed to add in the Ancestral Spirit. I might even remove both Harvest Golems. Anywho. The logic being.
Mind if I roll need?
Stalag and Fuegen are both. Well, they're both very good cards. Ooh, this is a tricky one. Actually, it's not that tricky at all. They are both very good cards. On the sort of vanilla test as well. I felt that I was kind of running out of steam in the later game against things like priests, for example, which do seem to be quite common at the moment. So the addition of Stalag and Fuegen were basically to kind of serve as big heavy 5 mana minions, but also had a good death rattle effect as well. So I guess one should assume a potential miracle against this particular rogue. So essentially, I can play them as 5 mana minions, even without their combo. But they also synergize quite nicely with Baron Geddon, Reincarnate as well, in terms of every now and again you're going to be able to summon a very cool 11-11 Thaddeus. Which is awesome. A 3 Wicked Knife. I also felt that, as has been aptly demonstrated here, the 4/4 minions and the ruby and eggs, while a very good minion, tend to get killed quite easily. So perhaps this deck needed something solid for the death rattles can raise. We're coming up to that point where miracles can start to become a little bit dangerous. Actually, this is one turn too early to do this. And I still have a very good life total because they haven't used all their removal on my minion. Maybe this isn't a miracle. Interesting. My misgivings with the Stalag Fuegen combo is that it seems to be quite easily neutralized, or at least my deck seems to be relatively easy at neutralizing it. Ooh, interesting.
This is our time, scrub.
Yeah, beat it.
Say, for example, using Hex and things like that. I don't have a particularly good way with dealing with that Yeti. If I reduce him to a 4/1, then he trades really well with the 4/4. It's a bit tricky. He trades really well with Stalag. Yeah, I think we do this.
Sustenance.
I think we make his trade slightly worse. We really can't just use one of the two attack minions to trade off against one of my 4/2s, which would be a bit of a disaster. So we seem to have a sort of value kind of rogue that we're fighting here. Perfect time for lightning storm, I think. Sorry about that. Have we had summoned a totem? Now we have to think about the trades. He can hit me for 6. What could he do with his minions? Trade unfavorably against me. It's a bit of a tricky one, I'm not sure about that. So I think he's going to sprint and trade. The 2-1 trades very well with my 4-2, which is annoying. Similarly, there's no really good trades here.
What to do?
We hold back a touch. He's just sprinted, which is annoying.
To Northrend! Victory!
So let's see what he can do. Struggling a bit with our card draw here.
I will be your death.
Okay, we're gonna go all face. Going a little bit thin here, I think. Oh, hello. Drawing. Well played by him, generally. I had a fairly slow start. He's doing pretty well. Can I prevent his lethal? 2, 4, 8, 11, 15. Not easily. Not very easily at all. Brave taunt.
Sorry.
Got it. Well, Well, never mind.
Well played.
Yeah. Less said about that, the better, really. Completely forgot about the taunt. Just hit me in the face. I really hate when people dance around. Just hit me in the face. You win. So infrequently that you have to dance around and show all the cards you could have played. I guess thinking about taking Bloodlust out. I go back and forth on Bloodlust. 3 extra attack to all your minions is kind of awesome and can win the game outright. I'm never sure whether Bloodlust is a win more card. I'm never sure in the games where I play it and it's really effective. I would have just won anyway, had I just kind of kept on with good board control.
The elements will destroy you.
I quite like this starting hand against the Shaman. Potentially want to replace the Lightning Bolt with something. Just trying to think what might be better. Feral Spirit? Is that a bit too greedy? The Lightning Storm I like because it does just clear lots of things. The Axe I like. We'll go with this.
Greetings, friend.
I also love the identical greeting. Though he's not going to do it.
I thank you.
Fine, whatever. Okay, let's have a totem off. Actually, I think the axe is a good keep against Shaman because I know that whatever else another Shaman's going to do, they're probably going to summon a totem at some point. Killing 3 totems for 3 mana is quite nice. Generally slows them down quite early.
Elements guide me.
I've also yet to see Swamp Oozes come back into the meta. I don't feel as worried about them as I used to. I know Trump runs a Harrison Jones. Okay. Lightning Bolt Axe. Continue, I think. Totem? Well, why not? I don't think it changes what I do because I don't think I want to trade. And also I'm happy to use up all the charges of the axe, especially when I have the Doom Hammer. The slightly easier to survive. Okay. I think I'm happy to Lightning Storm here and clear up survivors. This is kind of Shaman at its best. Fistful of answers to problems. With some stronger stuff to start playing on these turns. This is the kind of Shaman that was kind of getting routinely trounced in the previous meta. We've slightly run out of answers to problems. Slightly. Cantrips in my hand, and an interesting card. The egg. start getting the Stalag and Fuegan on the go. Which one do I want? Probably this one. I'm never 100% sure when I get new cards in my deck if I just play them because I like the fact that they're new cards rather than that they're the best play. Potentially a Drake might have been better there. Especially with the inevitable Lightning Storm that's in there. But this guy survives Lightning Storm. In combination with the Doom Hammer, he can finish off things that the Shaman might play next, like Fire Elemental, for example. And also the really nice thing about Stalag and Fuegan is I don't mind them dying, especially when I hold both of them. The ideal is to hold a Reincarnate in hand as well. Okay. Especially with in this mirror match, because Hex is a hard counter. It's really annoying. Oh, goodness. Good for him. Whoa, hitting that twice is going to be tricky. Okay. So we've got 3-4 damage. So shall we guarantee it? I think we probably should. Second Lightning Storm. Any other solutions? I like this. 3-1. Yeah, that's what he said. So I'm feeling quite happy about my position at the moment. I've got a couple of strong minions that I can play. I've got a Doom Hammer to deal with little things. Ooh, hello.
The Earth Mother is here.
I also have an answer to can. Right. Decisions. Do we need to deal with Cairn right now? I think we should deal with Cairn using two cards.
I wonder.
Then maybe I should play the Drake or the Doomhammer. I would have 8 mana on the next turn. Yeah, I think so. Oh, actually, yeah, that helps. Four damage. Earthshock. Envy Shaman, I do like to keep a tidy board because we have so many ways of activating our less worrying looking minions. Okay, again, the temptation is to play the Stalag Reincarnate. Still think a little bit of patience. Maybe keep that board clear. What can we do? 5, 6, 8 totem. Yeah, that seems good. To wait this one out.
What to
attention, class.
Ooh. Interesting addition to the deck. I quite like it. Lightning storm.
I am ready to learn.
Okay. Cool. Right, I think it might be time to cantrip. Yeah.
Hey, give me that!
Elements guide me. Elements guide me. Celebrush you.
Job done.
Master! But now you feel pain.
Deal with it. So that's lethal on the board. That is a scary board. Oh goodness, have you got the reincarnate Leroy? Oh, you're kidding me. I just don't have the mana for it. Well played, this.
Well played. You'll die now,
see, so Leroy is an addition to this deck. Leroy fit quite well, I think. This deck potentially a faster meta where you need to win by turn 4, but that was an example. Like, I just was able to wait him out, whereas perhaps last month I would have struggled to do that. This is me being a pedant. Let's put some shiny ones in just for the hell of it. I do like shiny cards. I don't think I have any other shiny ones. So this is the deck as it currently exists. And as you can see, it's curve. There's a lot of 5 mana minions. So the changes would be to kind of take out the Fuegan and Stalag and put in things like Harvest Golems early on. I think the cantrips are important. Because I think having a decent number of cards in your hand, a decent number of options to deal with what your opponents might throw at you is quite important. As I said, I'm still experimenting with this deck, but it seems to be doing quite well. In a slightly slowed down meta. In a post Warlock Zoo world.
Thrall versus Rexha.
Having said that, here we enter the Thunderdome somewhat.
Begin for Doomhammer.
Okay. Feral Spirit is great. Reincarnate, less great. Lightning Bolt. Not very many targets on turns 1, 2, and 3, so it'll probably just sit in my hand. It's good against the beasts that they summon on turn 3. But I think I want to play a Feral Spirit.
Job's done.
Nice thing at the lower levels is you see people making do when they don't have all the cards. And so you sometimes see things like Rivercon. Though having said that, there's a great Hunter deck at the moment, which I saw quite a lot towards the end of last month. I don't know what it's called in the meta. I've been calling it the Safari Hunter deck. Because it basically has every beast in it. And essentially uses the Starving Buzzard as a way of basically allowing a kind of zoo-like play, and you can just kind of play beast after beast after beast. Mm-hmm. 5 mana 2/5, whose name I can never really remember, and allows all your beasts to charge. we have a sort of value hunter. Okay. Choices. So I can use the flame tongue to kill that. That's like a card and a half for a card.
I wonder.
And it doesn't survive. Or I can just taunt up and wait. Not 100% sure about this play. But looks like this guy is playing quite a value deck, and I want to outvalue him. The Drake gets played in the next hand, on the next go round. So you could trade the River Croc and a spider if you wanted to. Oop. Or you could just trade a River Croc. Well done, sir. Face. Well played. I'm beginning to gain some answers. I think I should probably play. Also got both my hexes.
What to do?
So what's coming at me? Seven. Sorry, 9 points of damage. Breakout on the board.
To my side.
Goodness me. Lightning Storm would be great. That's the other change I've added, made to this deck, so I've added a second Lightning Storm. Mainly because I can afford it now. Starmark! Okay. So I think he's... Has he got lethal? 2, 4, 6, 9, 14. Yep, he does.
I wonder.
So we need to do something about that.
Job's done.
Great solution. I was tempted to hex last turn. I probably should have done. He got lucky with his beast draw. Grumble, grumble. Aggro hunter. It's the problem with playing a slightly slower deck, is you are going to lose the last one. If you don't have the answers in hand. Round and round the meta cycle we go.
Thrall versus Garrosh.
Victory or death for Doomhammer.
Okay. I'm not sure I like any of this. I want an Armorsmith killing card. Argent Commander kind of is, but I think Argent comes on a little bit too late. I believe that's one of the legendary card backs. I'm not 100% sure. It's slightly better than that. Which means that this might be a Control Warrior working their way back up. Thank you. we'll see. Nope. Or not. Or it might be face. Or it might have two fiery war axes and nothing else to do. Or it might be something that we've never seen.
What now?
Okay, the two mana fireball. Resource.
What now?
I have all my answer cards in hand. Including an egg buffing card. Which means that a lot of what's left in this deck are copies of these and my bigger minions. I feel quite happy about this draw. I like to get answers early on. Master. So,
I wonder.
It does tend to pop out a music of fiery war axe. That. Sorry, I'm talking to myself when I should be explaining what I'm doing. I was thinking of rock bitering the egg, which means that then you get a minion. In fact, you know, I think I'll do that. Death rattle order and all that. I'm trying to work out what would be able to fire a war axe in anything. Fine. That worked out quite nicely.
Always little time.
I forgot that the guy had one health. So I actually get a 4-4 minion. Whereas I thought I might get a 4-3, I miscalculated somewhat. And I've got a second egg on board. Axe my face. You're gonna axe my guy. Get another execute. Okay. Is it imperative that I play the Argent Commander on the next turn? Is it imperative that I kill that guy? Particularly. But I think I will. Beginning to be a bit card depleted. And I haven't drawn either of my drakes. And this basically allows him to armor up another 2 health. So me lightning bolting actually gives him 2 health, 2 extra health in some ways. Weird. Need to get into, it's probably okay to brawl this sort of range. But I feel okay, because I still have answers to his bigger minions. Used to be able to tell which brawl minion was going to survive. That is great. That's really cool. I think he has some ways of dealing 1 damage, so I think I'll probably lose the divine shield. At least either way. Yes, this is best. Sad. So double Argent Commanders. And now it's beginning to get awkward for him. Famous last words.
I bring life.
Cheers, Alex. I think we hex and carry on. Rather than trying to get fancy about things. So this is why I like Fuegan and Stalag. It's because, yes, the dream is to draw them both within a single game, for them both to die if you do get an 11-11 Thaddeus, but they're both pretty good minions on their own. They're effectively 5-6 worth of minion for 5 mana, with a good death rattle. They synergize quite well with the theme of the deck as a whole, so I think they're kind of good minions in their own right. That's my justification for running them anyway.
No time for games.
Sylvanas. Fortunately, I have 2 answers for Sylvanas as well. So. Is let's kill. I always forget which one's which. Let's kill Fuegan quickly. I think I hit you with the so we can get his awesome death rattle. In actual fact, that doesn't really help us win because we might never draw Stalag. So we might as well just keep on hitting the guy in the face for 4 and killing minions for 3.
That belongs in a museum.
The Harrison Jones. You're into the brawl. Okay. Whew. Okay. Totem lightning storm. Keep hitting the face. Do I need to kill the Bane? Difficult one. I know Fuegan definitely survives. I can answer it better on the next one. What am I going to use this card for? Hoopa! I think he's used both his armor, his shield blocks as well. That's what else I could use that card for.
Speak to me.
Beat our way through. Pressure up. These decisions. Do we have him next turn? He goes up to 10, and we have 2, 4, 5, 9 on the board. I think we keep hitting him. Maybe that wasn't the best play, but I think it's good to have a lot on the board, or kind of give him Brawl as basically his only out. So 2 in 9, about a 18% chance, give or take.
What now?
But he's got 3 cards in hand, but I don't know what they are. 5 out of 9. Just over 50% chance of drawing Brawl. That's pretty good. That's pretty good, actually. Okay. No Brawl. Cool. And we end today by staying in exactly the same place.